Hello students, welcome to our class and start your learning with Let's Learn. And our today's topic from chapter 1, Newton's Law of Motion. And topic is Newton's First Law of Motion. So students, just read these examples. What could be the reason for this following examples? The first is, a static object does not move without the application of force. What is the meaning of this? And a static object. Static object means the object that is at rest position. Understand? The object that is at rest is a static object. And static object does not move without the application of force. That means until the force is applied, the object will not move. The second example is, fruits on the tree fall down when its branches are shaken. When fruits on the tree fall down, when its branches are shaken. Then third example, an electric fan keeps on rotating for some time even after it is switched off. When you switch on the fan, after some time, when you keep switch off the fan, but for some seconds, the fan keeps on rotating. Do you know the answer of this three questions? Don't worry. You will get all the three answers in this, the first law of motion. From this topic, the first law of motion, Newton's first law of motion. So what is a statement? An object remains in state of rest or uniform motion. You know what is the uniform motion? Uniform motion means if any object travels the same distance in a same time interval is called the uniform motion. You know this meaning of the uniform motion. So any object remains in the state of rest or uniform motion in the straight line unless and until an external unbalanced force acts on it. I will tell you what is the meaning of the unbalanced, but just repeat, what is the statement? Any object remains in state of rest. That means any object remains in state of rest position, or any object continues to move in the uniform motion. First condition is any object remains in the state of rest position. In the state of rest position. Or second condition, any object continue to move in a uniform velocity, with uniform velocity, until any unbalanced force is applied on it. So what is the meaning of unbalanced force? I will tell you just for after some seconds. So one thing, the first law of motion is sometime also known as a law of inertia. This law is also known as a law of inertia. Understand what is the definition? So let's move on. What is a balanced force and unbalanced force? So balanced means a force where two forces of equal size acts on a body in opposite directions is known as balanced force. Just see here, for example, here this is a block and here two force, this is denoted by F1 and this is F2. If F1 equals to F2, that means the magnitude of the force are same. Magnitude means if F1 is equals to 10 Newton, for example, and F2 is equals to 10 Newton. So we can say the magnitude of both forces, F1 and F2, are same. But in a opposite direction, here you can see this is a block, anyway, and F1 is applied on this direction, and this F2 is applied on opposite direction. So what is the balanced force? A force where two forces of equal size acts on a body in opposite direction is known as balanced force. Same as here two force F1 and F2 are applied on this object. Here, magnitude of both F1 and F2 are equal. This is 10 Newton, this is 10. But the direction is opposite. The direction F1 and F2, direction of the both forces are opposite. So, this is known as a balanced force. In a balanced force, a body continues to be in its position. That means, if this block is at rest position, here F1 and F2, the magnitude of the F1 and F2 are same. So, this object remains at rest position, don't move. Why? Because the F1 is equals to F2, magnitude of F1 and F2 is equals to, and second condition is both applied in opposite direction. So that's why this object, if it is at rest position, it will continue remains at rest position. Understood? Second is an unbalanced force. A force where two forces acting in the opposite direction on a body are not equal in magnitude and in size. For example, if your this is your box F1, this force is F1, and the F2, this force is F2. If F1 is greater than F2, if F1, the force F1 is greater than F2, then this object moves in this side, that means in the side of the F1. This block moves in the direction of F1. Because why? Because the magnitude of F1 is greater than magnitude of F2. Understand? So this is called the unbalanced force. Understand? You can easily understand using with this picture. What is this? So this is a block, this is an object that is at rest position. Okay. When F1, here two persons applied the force, assume F1 and F2. The force F1 is applied from this person and F2 is applied by this person. When two forces are equal, same magnitude, but here direction are opposite. This person apply the direction in this direction and this person applied the force in this direction. That means the forces in the different direction, opposite direction. So these objects remains at rest position. Why? Because the F1 and F2 are equal. In a next picture, here both forces, that means the force applied by the two persons in the same direction. So these objects moves. This object, you can see here, these objects move from here to here. Understand? In this picture, an object that is a ball at rest, stay at rest position. If any boy or any person applied a force, unbalanced force. Why I say unbalanced force? Because this is applied by this person, this object, this boy. Okay. So, an object that is this ball in motion, stay in motion. And after, this is an obstacle, this net is an obstacle for ball. When ball is in motion and here this obstacle, then that means again unbalanced force is applied on the opposite direction to the ball. So the this unbalanced force change the speed and direction. First time ball is at rest position, a boy apply a force here, then ball moves in this direction, but here one obstacle, that is a net. So net applied the force in the opposite direction to the ball, so the direction of the ball will change because of the net. So this is an unbalanced force and balanced force. Here the two conditions, there are two conditions on which the Newton's first law of motion is depend on. What are these conditions? The number one, the object at rest position. When object is at rest position, that means the velocity of object is zero and acceleration is zero, because velocity is zero, so acceleration is also zero. So therefore the object continue to be at rest. Any object that is at rest, that object continue remains at rest position. Condition 2. motion, objects in motion. If any objects in motion, then these objects remain in the motion until any unbalanced force is applied on it. So, second condition, objects in motion. When an object is in motion, that means the velocity is not equals to zero because the object is in motion. While acceleration is zero because the object is in uniform motion. So, acceleration is zero and therefore the object will continue to be in motion, continue to be motion with the constant velocity and in the same direction. But after some time, some obstacle is here. Then, for example, let's see this picture. If this object is on motion, okay, this motion from here, after some time one obstacle is here, then this car stops because this obstacle, that means here unbalanced force, so the ball will the car will be on rest position. Okay, so these are two conditions for the Newton's first law of motion is dependent. Next, here are some examples of the Newton's first law. You can see here, this car moves with the uniform velocity. After some time, some obstacle here. When this car strikes through this wall or any obstacle, then this person falls in front size. Why? Because when this car strikes with this obstacle, this wall, then the body part that is touched with the seat of car, and then after this car driver apply the brake. So the body part that is touched with that seat of the car, that's move. If the car will stop, then the body part also will stop, but the upper body part will continue remove in the front size, so that this person will fall in front. Again, in this second example, this person travel by bus. This person is on the bus. When suddenly bus moves, then the body part of this person, that is the body part of this person, that is a leg. You can see here, when bus suddenly starts, then this body part, that is a leg, that is touch with the bus, contact in the bus. So when bus starts, that means when bus comes in the motion, then this leg comes in the motion with the bus, with the surface of the bus, but the upper body part that remains in the at rest position, that will remain at rest position just after when bus start. So that's why this person will fall in backside. You can see in this picture, just bus start, the leg also moves, but the upper body part that was at rest position before starting the bus, so that's why that person falls backside. But in this case, the car is in motion. When the obstacle is come in front of the car, the person apply the force, that means apply the brake. So the body part that is touched with the seat of the car, that stop after applying the brake. But the upper body part that continues move. Okay, so this person will fall in the front side. Understand? Next example here. In this example, first, this is a glass and this is a piece of cardboard. When we apply the force on the one coin is here, one coin in the center of the cardboard, and when we apply the force, we just apply the force on the cardboard, not on the coin. So the cardboard moves. But the coin that are on the cardboard, the coin is at rest position. When a cardboard moves, then the coin will fall under the glass. Understand? So this is the activity of the inertia. It is known as the inertia. Understand? This is glass. We keep the cardboard, the piece of the cardboard. Okay. And one coin, 5 rupee coin here. When we apply the force on the cardboard moves suddenly. And the coin remains at rest position. That's why the coin falls down in the glass. Understand? In this example, this is ball and this continuously moves. When this ball will stop? When any unbalanced force apply on it. The force may be air, or force may be if we stop the ball using our hand or any other objects, then this ball will stop. This is also one other example. This boy is moving on the bicycle. One obstacle is here, but at the starting the ball is moving. The boy is moving, but when obstacle is on the road, he apply the brake. But when he apply the brake, the body part that is contact with this seat, this just at rest position. Come at rest position, but the upper body part, that was moving before the brake, before applying the brake. So that's why this boy will fall in the front side. Understand? I hope you understand. If you have any query, if you have any doubt, please you can message me or comment on the Google Classroom. Using this code, you can get the homework, solutions and notes in the Google Classroom. Thank you very much.